For this lesson, you need to open the sample file, Sales First Quarter, from your Sample Files folder. In this lesson, we'll manipulate the vertical axis of a sales chart to give two entirely different views of a company's sales. Each chart will emphasize one of the following two true statements. It is true that sales are increasing every month. And it is true that sales are almost completely flat. You'll see how we can manipulate a column chart to visually convey each of these truths to an audience. After this session, you'll never look at a chart again without paying close attention to the vertical axis. This worksheet shows sales that are almost completely flat. Sales increased by 0.04% in February and by 0.05% in March. A 0.20% increase isn't anything at all. So imagine you're the sales director of the company and you need to have a pep talk with your salespeople. You want to show them a chart that demonstrates the lack of sales growth in order to motivate them to do better in April. To create the chart, I'll click on any of the cells within the range, then insert on the ribbon, and in the charts group, I'll click the Insert Column Chart button, and in the 2D column group, I'll choose the Clustered Column Chart Type. And the chart's automatically generated. But this isn't the chart you wanted at all. Sales actually look rather good. The reason that the chart isn't being as honest as it should be is because the vertical axis begins at 79,960. We're looking at the tips of columns that are very long. To fix things up, we need a more honest vertical axis, one that begins at zero. So I'll right-click the vertical axis element and then select Format Axis from the shortcut menu. And the Format Axis task pane appears. Notice there's an option here for the minimum and maximum axis values. So I'll change the minimum to zero and press the Enter key. And you can see that the chart now depicts a more honest representation of flat growth. And look at the task pane again and notice how Excel has automatically managed the other settings. Major units for grid lines, that's the interval between numbers on the vertical axis, have now changed to 10,000. Let's change the minor unit grid line value to 5,000. So I'll remove the current value of 2,000 and type 5,000 in the box. Just a point here, you cannot put a comma between the 5 and the 1,000. Excel won't recognize a value that's formatted in that way. You might be disappointed to see that nothing's happened on the chart, and that's because we're not currently showing minor horizontal grid line elements. In a moment, we're going to enable the display of the minor grid line elements, and then we'll expect to see one minor grid line between each major grid line. So first, I'll dismiss the Format Axis task pane. Then I'll make sure that the chart is activated by clicking just inside the border. And then I'll click the Chart Elements button. I'll hover over the Grid Lines element and then click the Fly Out Menu button. And you can see that, at the moment, I'm showing primary major horizontal grid lines, but I'm not showing the primary minor horizontal grid lines. So I'll click the checkbox next to primary minor horizontal, and you can see that minor grid lines are now being shown on the chart. I'll just click in a blank cell now to dismiss the menus. Just a few words on grid lines before we close this lesson. First of all, too many grid lines can make a chart difficult to read. This lesson's chart looks cluttered with minor grid lines, and might even look cleaner without any grid lines. And just one other tip on grid lines is that when you do use grid lines, always choose a light colour to focus attention upon the foreground elements. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales First Quarter 1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 521, Add Grid Lines and Scale Axes.